workout in the workout facilities, because the Ritz-Carlton gives me exclusive privileges because I've been going down there for almost 20 years. And so the oil man called me over there and wanted me to have a discussion with him about his oil. But I wanted to let him know, I have some oil you need. It's the Holy Ghost. Now, the oil man is supposed to have the Holy Ghost. He's Church of God in Christ. He said Bishop Blake, who took over for Bishop Patterson, was coming to Detroit to Bishop Brooks Church, and he wanted me to come over there. I did not have time for that. I don't have anything against Dwight Pate, since I probably will be on TV with this. He's down there selling a lot of oil, and hundreds and thousands of people are gathering at these churches to buy oil from Dwight Pate. Someone say the oil man. But that oil won't save you. But what we preach will save you. If you get this oil, you can't buy this in a barrel. You got to get this from God. Now, how do you get this oil? Turn to verse 32 again. Let's read. And we are his witnesses of these things, and so is also the Holy Ghost, whom God have given to them that obey him. So who gets the Holy Ghost? Who gets the Holy Ghost? Them that obey him. So you can go down to the oil man's meetings and buy some oil. You still don't have God. Now, he may have told you that God is in the oil. That oil won't keep you from sin. That oil won't bear witness that your sins has been forgiven. That oil that he sells will not bring any salvation. But this oil comes from the Prince and Savior whom we preach, whose name is who? And he gives repentance, forgiveness of sins, and then gives the Holy Ghost to them that obey him. And this is the oil that all those people lining up in that church need to be hearing about. If he was preaching the same message that Peter just got through preaching here to the Sanhedrin when they were putting them on trial and placing their lives on the line. Their lives were being placed on the line, and all the people said. So turn to someone and say, I don't need the oil man. No, and the Dwight Pate may be listening to this. I'm not putting him down. I'm just saying he needs to preach this message. The oil man needs to take this message. This is the oil that they need. Someone say the oil man. Oh, well, we don't need that. We need God. So this should be understood. What you want, I want, we want the Holy Ghost. Jesus said, the Apostle Paul said, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is. He said in the first chapter of the book of Acts, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. They don't need to be buying any oil. They need to receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. They can only get that from the Prince and Savior, whose name is what? All right, now let's go to Acts 15. And verses 15 through 17. Can the church say amen? Acts chapter 15, verses 15 through 17. And some say, well, why is it, and even though this is an application here, why is it you call the name of Jesus over the candidate in baptism? Is that necessary? Well, you should declare that you're baptizing the candidate in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. Peter made that declaration on the day of Pentecost. It is our instruction from the apostolic fathers and the board of bishops who are responsible for the 11 pages of doctrine found in our minute book and for the interpretation of the scriptures that we teach as an organization, for us to follow the instruction and the formula that they have given us for baptism. Now, if a person has faith in his name, and we pray for them to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost, and they come to be baptized, and we simply say, we now baptize you in Jesus' name, or do you believe in Jesus died for your sins, and I now will baptize you in Jesus' name, and you baptize them, whether you whisper the name Jesus, or whether you shout the name Jesus, or whether you declare the name Jesus before you baptize them and don't say it again, it's not going to determine whether or not their sins are washed away. They should acknowledge they're being baptized in Jesus' name, You should have the authority to baptize them in Jesus' name. You should acknowledge that you are baptizing them in Jesus' name. You should declare that acknowledgement because it is required in the scripture for the declaration to be so. But whether or not you repeat the formula to the jot and tittle is not of significance. The fact of the matter is, though, we've been given a formula and we need to be obedient. So if we have been given a formula and we need to be obedient, and that formula is not contrary to the scripture, but is in conformity to the scripture, we need to baptize people in water in Jesus' name. And all the people said, all right, in Acts 15, verses 15 through 17, now this is at the doctrinal conference that is going on in the 15th chapter of the book of Acts. And they're dealing with the question concerning the law of Moses and circumcision, because it is said in verse number 5 here in the writing where they're talking about Paul and Barnabas got into a argument over whether or not the Gentiles had to keep the law. And this question came up, and it talks about in verse number 5 who they were arguing with. It says, but there arose up certain of the sect of the Pharisees which believed, saying that it was needful to circumcise them, that is the Gentiles, and command them to keep the law of Moses. This was causing a problem. Turn to someone and say a problem. This shows you that there sometimes are disagreements in the church. Now, if you look in here, you will see it talks about in verse number 7. Let's read verse 7 out loud together again. Read. And when there had been much disputing. Now, so what were they doing? So there is and are arguments between leaders. This is leaders. This was a situation in which there was disputing going on among leaders as to whether or not people had to keep the law of Moses to be saved. That is, keep those 613 ordinances and refrain from eating anything but kosher foods and all of the other things that Jesus had nailed to the cross, whether or not they had to continue to adhere to those things and whether or not those things had anything to do with salvation. You see, this is the problem we have today. Preachers are bringing in any and everything into the church that have nothing to do with salvation. And this is why when people come to churches now, they should hear the gospel, but they're not hearing the gospel. Much of what they're hearing is preachers preaching blessings to get money. And that's just the unfortunate thing. No matter where you go, we may seem to run into this because people are trying to transform churches into dens of thieves so that they can raise money to line their pockets to support their living or to support their, someone say, lifestyle. This is not appropriate, but this is what's going on. But you should notice in verse 7, there was much what? Disputing. There was much disputing that was going on among the leaders of the church. And they had to get together at a conference to settle this issue. And they did. There was a conference called in Jerusalem to settle this issue. Are you listening to me? So you would see this if you read on here in the scripture. I guess we will read on. Since we're in verse 7, we might as well read right on, verse 7. And when there had been much disputing, what happened? Peter rose up and said unto them, men and brethren, you know how that a good while ago, someone said, God made choice among us that the Gentiles by my mouth should hear the word of the gospel and believe. You should mark this scripture. Because Peter said that the Gentiles by my mouth. Well, why was it by the mouth of Peter? Turn to someone and say, because he was given the keys. The reason why Peter was the mouthpiece that God used is because God had given him the keys. The keys that God gave him was the gospel. The keys, which was the gospel that he used, were used 10 years after Pentecost, in the 10th chapter of the book of the Acts of the Apostles, when he preached to Cornelius and his household.